Hello and welcome to Music Spotlight. I'm Pema and today I'm very excited to present to you my guest, beautiful and very talented Jurmi Chhojen and a brilliant guitarist from O Strangers, BJ. Please welcome to our show.
Thank you.
And please greet our viewers.
Kuzuzangpola, my name is Jurmi Chhojen Rinzen. I'm a bebop singer from M Studio and I'm also a student at the Royal Thimphu College. Happy to be here.
Hello, love. My name is BJ, and I'm a graduate, and I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
Okay. So it's a pleasure to have you guys on the show today. And you know, then, as always, my very first and foremost question is, what does music mean to you?
Music for me is, it's a very beautiful thing for me because it's something I always grew up with and I was always surrounded with, and it's comforted me when I needed it, and it's also empowered me in a lot of ways. So for me, it's something that I not only enjoy, but something that empowers me, I think.
How about Vijay?
Music for me is an art that I really envy and want to live into it. So for me, music is an art, so.
Yeah, so for each one of us, we have different take on what music means to us, right? But for Jurmi, it empowers her, and for Vijay, it's an art, right? Okay, so now coming to Jurmi, you know, when did you start singing?
I think ever since I was really young, I find these videotapes in my house, and I'm like 3 years old singing Oitasha.
Oh, okay.
So I've always been singing at home, but at the studio, I first started in 2017, I went to M Studio, and that was when I first recorded.
Okay, so you recorded your first song in 2017?
Yes, like my first cover at M Studio.
Okay. How about Vijay? When did you start playing guitar?
I started playing guitar when I was, I think, 10 or 11 years old. Since then, I started playing, but I did not really start practicing.
Okay.
So that's where I differentiate between playing guitar and practicing it. So initially, my playing of my guitar would date back to when I was 10 years old.
Wow, okay.
But I started practicing more seriously after 15 years old.
Ah, okay. So, lead guitarist of Oh Strangers Verse in Makings since 10 years old, right? Okay, so, you know, like for Jurmi, I know that you have some original songs, right?
Yes.
So do you write your own songs or you take help from others?
It was something that was very new for me because I've never done that before. But I wrote my first original song, Shashok Pangantur, for the Bebop show, which was organized by M Studio. And after that, it's been a lot easier for me to write my own hooks and verses. So I've been writing my own songs.
So, you know, like now, may I ask, you know, what inspired you to write that, your first song?
It was basically, so I never wrote a song before, and we all had to write our own original songs for that because the theme of that show was to encourage originality and bring out what was, you know, us in a song. And I told Acho I didn't know what to sing, so he told me to just write my own experiences. And that was the time when I just came back to Bhutan after living in Australia for 4 years. And I just wrote what I saw when I came back. I saw many changes, and I was really happy with how my country developed, and was really proud to be Bhutanese. And yeah, so I wrote Shashok Pangantur based on the experience.
So you portrait what you are feeling through your songs,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
So now, you know, like, if you can tell me about what genre do you usually sing or prefer to sing?
The genre that I sing is called bebop. It's not Rixar, and it's not like any other genre. It's not traditional. It's something that's very contemporary and original, and it's a genre that comes from M Studio. So I classify myself as a bebop artist.
Okay. Bebop artist. And for Vijay, you know, what genre do you usually, you know, is into?
I come from a rock background. Okay. Since I was a young kid, I always enjoyed playing rock and listening to rock. But after I joined the band, I had to compromise certain things. But still, and I wanted to blend the Bhutanese type of feel with the rock element to it. So that's how I define music for me. So I mostly, right now, I mostly alternative rock with a traditional feel to it.
Okay. So both of you, you have your own genre, right? And then, you know, like bebop, I think it's a new thing in Bhutan. Or
it's very contemporary, like, yes, it's very contemporary, but it's basically pop, what is popular, what majority of the people would enjoy listening, or what is played on the radio. But bebop is a kind of pop that can only be found in Bhutan because there are Bhutanese elements, and that is basically our identity within our genre. So that's the essence.
So we have a lot more coming up, but before that, let's listen to their song, Send My Love, a cover song by Jurmi and accompanied by Vijay. Please enjoy the song. We'll be back.
This was all you, none of it me. You put your hands on my body and told me, ooh, tell me you were ready for the big one, for the big jump. Be your last love, everlasting you and me. That was what you told me. I'm giving you up by forgiving it all. You set me free. Yeah. Send my love to your new lover and treat her better. You gotta let go of all of our ghosts. We both know we ain't kids no more. Send my love to your new lover and treat her better. You gotta let go of all of our ghosts. We both know we ain't kids no more. I was too strong, you were trembling. You couldn't handle the hot heat rising. Baby, I'm surprising. I was running, you were walking. You couldn't keep up, you were falling down. There's only one way down. I'm giving it all. You set me free. Send my love to your new lover and treat her better. You gotta let go of all of our goals. We both know we ain't kids no more. Send my love to your new lover and treat her better. You gotta let go of all of our goals. We both know we ain't kids no more. Ooh, we ain't kids no more. You gotta let go of all of our goals. We both know we ain't kids no more. We ain't kids no more. Thank you.
Coming to your musical influences, who do you look up to or where do you take your inspirations from?
I have a lot of artists that inspire me, but I would say that my biggest inspirations would be Adele and Rihanna. And also, Namkhal Ham, I've always enjoyed listening to her. Okay. So, yes.
Our very own Mutinous singer, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Your influences, it varies, right? You said it's Adele and Namkhal Ham and Rihanna. So I think it's apparent from your songs you have performed today that, but you also have your own individuality, I would say, originality. So it's a good thing, right? And for Vijay, how about you? Like, who is your musical influences?
My inspiration changes over time. When I was a young child, I had a different inspiration that I used to look up to. And when then gradually it changes over time. It changes over time because of my need. If I want to do something, I would get inspiration from something or somewhere else. It doesn't have to be a musician. It can be a poet, right? A poet or a football player. Okay. I just need inspiration in how they work so that I can apply that their work ethic to my work in music. So I don't specifically have an inspiration for now. Maybe I'll have in future too, after 2 years, so it might differ from me.
Okay. All of us are changing, right? Evolving with time. So even your taste for music and things you do, how you do your music depends on the change you're experiencing, right?
Totally.
Okay. So for Jumi, you have your own original songs, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And which one is your favorite, you know, among your many songs?
I don't think I have a favorite in particular, but I haven't done that many originals also to have a favorite yet. A lot of my original pieces are either just the chorus or just the verse because I collaborate with other artists and rappers. But I think my favorite too would be Shashuk Pangang, which I sang before because that was my first one. Okay. So it's like my special piece because it was the first thing I ever did. Okay. And I think Yewazang, which I wrote with Achichoying Jatsu from M Studio, because I think that song makes me really happy and it really represents how I feel about my country.
Oh, wow.
So I would say those two.
Yeah. So, you know, like listening to Yewazang, it really invokes patriotism in you, I think, and happiness and proud you feel as a Bhutanese, right?
Yes, like, it really represents how I feel about my country because I'm sure we all feel just as proud, and I wanted to put that in a song, and Acho and I came up with that song.
Yeah. So, and now, you know, like, I have watched one of your song with, I think you did it with Kilewanchu, Tedari.
Oh, yes, la.
So how did it happen?
Actually, that isn't that's not my original song. That song was originally performed by Kilewanchu and Ugin Pandey. So it was. It's written mostly about suicide prevention and mental illness. And to celebrate World Suicide Prevention Day last year, we did a live cover of it on M Studio. And that song really makes me feel happy as well because it's kind of like a ray of hope, telling people out there that, you know, this life is short and it's difficult, but you'll make it and we'll be there. And it highlights social issues such as mental illness. So I think that song is really important.
The song is very meaningful indeed. And I think at this time and age, with all the things happening.
Yes,
I think we need some boost, you know, yes, to keep going, right? Mm-hmm. And then your song, Sidari, is exactly what we need, I think.
It was written by Achukilohan Shula. He's very passionate about the issue.
I hope I can get him on the show one day.
Yes.
Okay. With this, we'll listen to Jeremy's next song. That's One That Got Away, a cover song. Please enjoy the performance. We'll be back.
Summer after high school, when we first met, we'll make out in your Mustang to Radiohead. And on my 18th birthday, we got matching tattoos. Used to steal your parents' liquor and climb to the roof. Talk about our future like we had a clue. I never planned that one day I'd be losing you. But in another life, I will be your girl, and we keep all our promises. It's us against the world. Someone said you had your tattoo removed. Saw you downtown singing the blues. It's time to face the music. I'm no longer your muse. But in another life, I will be your girl, and we keep all our promises. It's us again.
You being a singer in our country, Bhutan, and what are some of the challenges, you know, you face as a singer and a performer, I would say?
Well, I would say that the experience is mostly positive. It's very rewarding. But there are a few challenges, especially for people like BJ and I, because we're also students. Okay. And we also have other responsibilities that don't include music, and music is a hobby, so it's very, I would say it's a little bit challenging to try and balance everything out and give attention to everything, because music is really rewarding, but at the same time we have to also focus on school and on our studies. So I think it's a challenge to balance that. Another thing that's really challenging as a musician, especially working with originals, is to try and make sure everybody is at the same level when it comes to issues such as copyright or, you know, paying properly and all that. But I think that's a part of any society that is just introduced to something like having independent musicians. So it's not so challenging, but these are some of the issues that we do face.
Yeah, right. So, yeah, some the issues you listed can be, you know, like, maybe because of our country still at infancy, I would say, when
yes,
it comes to music.
We're very new, so it's only natural that it happens, and the rate at which we're going is really amazing. I'm very impressed at the music scene here in Bhutan.
Okay.
Challenges for me looking at the experiences of many musicians and myself, it's mostly financial. Firstly, finance. Second is how society perceives musicians. So, they don't. I have noticed most of the people, not all, most of them, label musicians as to not a dignified job. They do not invade musician in a such a way that how people would invade a person who works a 9 to 5 p.m. job. So how the society perceives them, and the financial status of the musician, it's not at par. So it's a struggle, you know. We have to sacrifice a lot of things in order to follow our passion, but practically we all must come down and think about it if we really want to pursue this career or not.
As we mentioned earlier, that the music scenario in Bhutan is still at infancy, right? But at the rate at which you mentioned, yeah, it's improving, yeah. But at the same time, maybe it's because of the, you know, like the stability our parents wants us to have, you know. So they think that having a job, 9-to-5 job, is stable.
They idolize that kind
of
job.
Yeah. But I think, you know, like with lots of singers like yourself coming up and with lots of talent like yours, it might take some time, but it's already evolving. But, you know, in a few years, Jurmi might establish her own record label and, you know, start producing lots of new singers and encouraging them. Yeah. And even for Vijay, you know, you are a brilliant guitarist. And I really hope, you know, you keep this passion going on regardless of the challenges. And with dreams comes challenges, right?
Yes.
So let's take it positively, all right? So now, you know, like with the current situation, COVID-19, how are singers like yourself coping with the situation? If you could tell us, you know?
I think I would have more a perspective of a student than a singer, or, you know, both. But COVID-19 has changed things for all of us, so it hasn't been something that's just affected singers or students. But having to study online and also not having any more gigs, of course we've had Chikthin, it was a really great initiative by BVS, but we haven't really had the platform to perform live. And we had a lot of plans for the summer. We had a lot of performances and festivals that we were planning, but we did have to cancel them, so it affected us a bit. But we're still happy that we can sing for Chikthin, sing here, and, you know, sing online and just spread the love. So, yeah.
With all these things going on and you choosing to come on Music Spotlight is a big thing for us as well. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
And for Vijay, you know, I know that you as a band perform gigs, right? So how has it affected you guys?
It surely has affected, because the last time we came as a band to perform at Chikthin, we were very nervous. We had not performed together for several months. So it was a big challenge for us. We were very nervous. And, you know, the vibe we get is not the same. The vibe we get is the nervousness. Okay. It is not the feel of music that we play, but, you know, it's like, it's more of a, who might make the next mistake?
Okay.
Am I going to make the flaw now? So it's kind of that kind of tension. So the connections or the connectivity between ourselves, that has degraded a lot. So... not financially, of course, it will affect. But you know, being playing in a band and the musicianship and the practice time, it has affected, you know, in every aspect, not in one but in everything.
Yeah. So for everyone, it has changed things. You know, like, yeah. But what we can do is hope for the best, right?
Mm-hmm.
Make good use of the opportunity given, right? Jurmi, you being a student and a performer who is a very, you know, talented performer. So what is your favorite part of, you know, of the job, I would say?
I think that both of what I do is, they're very interconnected, because both of us, BJ and I, we both studied political science and sociology, and it's a really interesting course where we get to learn about society and get to see the world through a sociological lens, a different lens. And so when I do music, I get the opportunity to actually step into these subcultures, these subgroups in society. I get to observe the society as well as practice my art that I enjoy. And while I'm observing the society, I get to apply everything that I learned in school. So I think these two experiences for both of us, right? Yeah. I think for both of us, these two experiences together really help to enrich the way we see the world. We feel like we are getting to learn a lot more. And of course, we enjoy the art itself. So it's a really positive experience for us.
Okay. So that's a very beautiful way of putting it in, you know? And so with this, we'll take in the next song.
When you were here before, couldn't look you in the eyes. You're just like an angel. Your skin makes me cry, and you float like a feather. So very special, but I'm a creep, and I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I said I don't care if it hurts. I wanna have control. I want a perfect body. I want a perfect soul. And I want you to so very special, oh, but I'm a creep, and I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I said
you're watching Music Spotlight, and that was Creep by Jurmi Chodan and Vijay. As we talked earlier about the challenges you face as a singer. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, what kind of opportunities would you like to be given after, you know, all this current situation is over?
In terms of the music scene?
Yes.
Or, yeah. I think one of my biggest dreams is to have mainstream and non-mainstream music integrated. I think that would be the most beautiful thing, because in Bhutan, we are so lucky to have so many different genres of music traditionally, and we have contemporary music, and with a fusion, we have that as well. We have so much power in our music, and I think that representation would be really nice. I would like to recommend or maybe request for a proper integration of all these different genres. Maybe in the film industry, if they can have like a rock band like BJ's, or you know, or something completely different, but with Dzongkha, with our own identity being very strong. And I think with that, we have the potential to really market our music to the international community as well. So I'd like to see that happen.
So how about Vijay?
For me, being in an alternative rock band, I would want the society and the audience to accept the music more. I know, and we all accept that rock has faded away from the world itself, and what rock used to be in the 80s is not the same now. Okay. So the pop, like Jimmy Sharon's pop music, has taken over the world now. So, but still, then in Bhutan, it's a new thing. You know, blending rock music with the traditional sound is something that I would want the people to accept it. And what I've noticed till now is the songs we have, you know, our band's song, are not listened to by, you know, not all the people. People might say that, you know, our songs are mostly listened by the younger generation, but that is not the case as well. The younger generation people are more inclined or more towards the bebop or the pop genres, but they usually do not like it. So if audience could, you know, but the people could accept the alternative rock feel to it. So
also, if I may emphasize that with young musicians like myself and Bijay and many others, we would like to tell the audience, firstly, that we're not trying to, we're not going to forget our culture. If anything, culture is something that's constantly changing, and you cannot stop culture from changing. However, we want to protect our culture, but with our own style and our own art. And I think that is what we would like to tell the audience. And for other young musicians, we would like to tell them not to forget your culture. Because at the end of the day, what makes us different from a band or a singer in Indonesia or America is our Bhutanese identity. And we can really use that to further our music as well as protect our culture. So we just wanted to highlight on that.
And if we do that, it is being in a very competitive world. We cannot compete with the musicians that are abroad. If we try to replicate what they are doing, you know, we lack in a lot of things. So that would be a positive point for us. If we blend the traditional music to be rock, pop, jazz, blues, anything, and blend it with the traditional music, they would not sound like us. We will not sound like them. So it is a marketing strategy as well for the music scene.
It's what we have that nobody in the world will have is our culture. And I think we need to protect it like anything and use it in our art.
Yeah. And the way, you know, like you guys are, you know, trying to blend modern with traditional, I think you're on the right way. It might take some time, but I think you're on the right way, and there might come a time, you know, where we can probably say that, you know, on the global platform that yes, this is Bhutanese, yeah, right?
Yes.
So I think if you go on like this, I think it won't take long for us to, you know, really bring our Bhutanese music out to the global platform.
Hopefully.
Yeah, I think with talent like yours, and there are many talents, yeah. So I think, as you mentioned, that if we keep our, you know, culture intact as well as evolve ourselves, I think we can really make an impact in global market as well. And now we know, like, and then the perfect example would be like Oostranger's Nose Ip, right? Perfect blend of
traditional
and your alternative. Yeah, that one. So I think that's an example as well. And I'll look forward to, you know, you guys paving way towards global market as well.
Hope so. That's the dream.
You have collaborated with some of our own Bhutanese artists, right?
Yes.
So how did the collaboration between Kilirik Sinduji and Sangye Wangchen happen?
Yes, so those two are my most recent collaborations. Sangye Wangchen is a member of it. He's also another B-pop artist at M Studio. And we always wanted to write a song together, so that just happened. And with Kilirik Zin, he's currently in America, and he actually sent me a message asking me to sing a short part of his song. And I was really happy and honored to be able to collaborate with him. So okay, that's how it happened.
Okay, so he being outside and you being here, how did you, you know, manage to bring together?
Yes, this is something that a lot of artists are doing these days. So I just record my part here, and he sends his recording from there, and we mix it here or there. And yeah, it's really possible. So during COVID, we're doing that more. Even with artists here, we're trying to record from our own stations in order to avoid crowding and for social distancing purposes.
So keeping in mind the safety of everyone, right?
Yes,
okay, so that's a good thing, you know, good example, I would say. And, you know, like yesterday I was watching your collaboration with Sangye Wangchen. So what is it about? You also acted in it, right?
Yes. It's actually a song that it speaks of a love story. It's a fictional love story.
Okay.
Of somebody who is stuck in a relationship but is not able to get out of it. And even though she sees better options, she's still kind of dependent on her previous relationship.
Mm-hmm.
And the song, at a glance, you wouldn't expect it to be representing these social issues, but it does represent toxic relationships and about, you know, having options to explore, and you know, if you're in a bad place, you can come out of it. It's that kind of message.
Okay, and it's about time that we address these issues, right?
Yes.
As simple as dating.
Yes.
So there are many dating violences,
mm-hmm.
and yeah. So you know, your song might help somebody to, you know, what do you say, like, make them realize that they're in a toxic relationship.
Yes,
so I think that's a good initiative. And for Vijay, you accompanied Jurmi today, right? So how is it working with Jurmi?
For me, it's an opportunity for me being able to play guitar for Jurmi. To be honest, I'm not doing this because she's my friend, but for the fact that she's an amazing singer. So being able to, you know, assist her in her performances, it gives me an experience, a learning process for me, and also, you know, give me a new light in the bebop area.
Okay.
For me, I'm mostly sticking my own genre, but when I play with her, I have to stick around with many genres. So it, you know, it's, I can be more versatile. So.
Okay.
So she gives me that
get
experience.
To learn many things,
yes.
on the way, right? Okay, so how about Jurmi? How is it working with Vijay?
It's really comfortable, I would say, and very easy because we've been friends for a few years now. We went to college together. I think Vijay is a flexible enough guitarist that he can play any genre, any song. Sometimes I don't even tell him what song we're going to play, and I show him a bunch of chords, and he's probably never heard that song before, but he can still keep up, and he can keep up with any style, any singer, and I really appreciate that. And it's really good for an artist like me who does so many genres impromptu, so Vijay is really flexible like that.
Okay, so that shows his brilliance in guitar, right?
Yes.
His expertise in guitar. Okay, so with this, we'll take in the next song.
Came to win, to fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to win, to survive, to prosper and rise, to fly. To fly. Today it will rain all day. Maybe that will kind of make the pain go away. Trying to forgive you for abandoning me. Praying, but I think I'm still an angel away. Angel away, yeah, strange in a way. Maybe that is why I chase strangers away. They got the guns out aiming at me, but I become new when they're aiming at me. Me, me, me against them. Me against enemies, me against friends. Somehow they all seem to become one. A sea full of sharks and y'all smell the blood. They start coming and I start rising. Must be surprising, I'm just demising. A win, thrive, soar, hey yeah. Hiya, hiya, more fire. I came to win, to fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to win, to survive, to prosper, to rise, to fly. To fly. Everybody wanna try to box me in, suffocating every time it locks me in. Painting their own pictures and they crop me in, but I will remain where the top begins. Cause I am not a word, I am not a line, I am not a girl that can ever be defined. I am not fly, I am levitation, I represent an entire generation. I hear the criticism loud and clear, that is how I know that my time is near. So will they come alive in the time of fear? And I ain't really got no time to spare. Cry my eyes out for days upon days, such a heavy burden placed upon me. But when you go hard, your nays become yays. Yankee Stadium with Jays and Kanyes. I came to win, to fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to win, to survive, to prosper, to rise, to fly. To fly. I came to fly. Thank you.
You're watching Music Spotlight, and that was Fly, a cover song by Jurmi. While writing songs and doing music, what kind of message do you want to promote through your songs?
I think there are a few things that I would like to address. Firstly, as I've already said before, through my original songs, I would like to promote Bhutanese culture and to always include a hint of Bhutanese culture no matter what you do, whether it's playing the damyan in the background of a pop song or anything, to always hold on to that. As an artist and to other artists, I would also like to emphasize on the importance of copyright and to understand intellectual property. And I think because it's a very new phenomenon in Bhutan, it makes sense that it's not as well as widespread as it should be, but it's on the way. I'd just like to tell everyone that the music that we make is our intellectual property. It's our creation that, you know, it belongs to the artist. And so if people from variety shows, you know, to any kind of variety shows to platforms where they play our music, if they could, ideally, if they could, you know, talk to the artist and work on what they will be compensating for using the song. If not, at least to request permission and to have that mutual agreement on the use of our art. I think it's very important to understand copyright laws, and I know that the Department of Intellectual Property here has so many, they have so much information on their website, and they're always willing to help us. So if artists and audience and these platforms, business platforms that use our music, if all of us could collaborate on truly strengthening copyright and protecting the art of the artist, I would be very grateful. So yes, that's a plea. Okay.
So it's about time that the credit should be given where it is due, right?
It's not just about credit as well. It's more like if it's other things, people already understand that this is a property. But when it comes to art, because it's such a public thing that everybody listens to, everybody can access on SoundCloud, so people don't see the importance to be as equal as other properties when in reality it is. So it's just something that it would be really nice if these platforms, especially the big platforms like reality shows, could understand that.
Yeah. So yeah, it's high time that we, you know, acknowledge the, as you said, the property of artists. And that's if we acknowledge it, so that's how we are going to encourage each other, right? And how about Vijay, do you have anything to add on?
Add on the copyright?
Yes.
I recently had this conversation with Jumi and Ashwin from M Studio, and for me as well, the thing of copyright is a very new thing for me as well. I believe many of the artists around Bhutan are unaware about this issue, and it was really properly said and explained to me by, you know, Ashwin He told me the importance of it. He even cited one example of a vehicle. You know, he said, if you own a vehicle, would you give your vehicle to another person so that he can use it as a cab and earn money from your vehicle? So I think that was a very good example for me in understanding the meaning of copyright. So the music that we produce or other artists produce, and if we try to earn money through their music, it is my wrong, you know, my wrongdoing. So I have to seek permission in order to do that. I don't think anyone would say no. Being a very small country and having a very small society, people would encourage and support other artists to, you know, give their songs for their financial benefit. So it is a matter of a permission.
Okay.
So that is what I understood from Jeremy Chodin and Achishwing about this copyright thing.
And at M Studio, we're actually practicing it very diligently because we thought we'll start with ourselves. Yes. And we're spreading awareness about it. And even for Jigtin, so M Studio has been performing at Jigtin for about 16 weeks now. And within the span of 16 weeks, every time our artists would sing someone else's song or do a cover, we made sure to go and ask permission from the original artist, whether they're in Bhutan or not, whether the song is 10 years old or 15 years old or 1 month old. We all went out, asked permission, and everything was done very, like, in the correct procedure. So we would like to encourage everyone else to also follow the same.
Okay. So it's, you know, it's very good that you address it today as well. So I hope, you know, our viewers also take this meaningful message from, you know, about copyright issues from this, from Jurmi and Vijay, and I hope you really understand the importance of copyright. And by acknowledging their intellectual property, I think we will be encouraging them as well as practicing a healthy way of, you know, promoting our intellectual property, right?
Yes.
Okay, so with this, we'll take in the next song.
Yes, I do. I believe that one day I will be where I was, right here, right next to you. When it's hard, the days just seem so dark. The moon and stars are nothing without you. Your touch, your skin, where do I begin? No words can explain the way I'm missing you. Deny this emptiness, this hole that's inside. These tears, they tell their own story. Told me not to cry when you were gone, but the feeling's overwhelming. It's much too strong. Can I by your side, next to you, you, make sure you're all right, I'll take care of you. I'm reaching out to you. Can you feel my heart? This hurt that I've been through, I'm missing you. I'm missing you like crazy. Told me not to cry when you were gone. Feelings overwhelming, it's much too strong. Can I lay by your side next to you? Take care of you.
that was Lay Me Down, a cover song by Jurmi. And now, if you could tell me, when you are not singing, what do you like doing in your free time?
I enjoy doing a lot of things. I love to travel. I love to learn languages. And I also like spending time with my family. And I enjoy doing research and studying our course. I think we both do, right? Yes.
Okay. When I'm not doing music, I love spending time with my friends. I believe I have different circle of friends. Okay. One is my music friends, through which I have the relationship with them. And another group is that I have who are not a part of music. So whenever I'm having time for music, I do not have time for my other friends. So what I do is I want to spend more time with my people who are my friends who are not a part of music.
Okay, so that's how you balance your time with music and your friends, right? Okay. So do you have any plans for new albums or new songs?
I think I always have plans, always have new ideas. And as I've said before, because I love to volunteer and I really feel like I love to contribute to society and highlight social issues. Every time there is a social issue that really touches me or inspires me, I think I would write a song about that. So I have a few plans left.
Okay. So we'll look forward to your new songs or an album. So how about Vijay? Do your band have any plans for new albums?
Not as album, but maybe singles, maybe. Okay. But okay. We have not really decided or started working on it. The process is not started or it is yet to begin. But of course, we would love to start working on new projects.
Okay. So, you know, talking to you guys, you know, I found it really enriching for me because as much as I don't like to admit, but I really, you know, didn't understand about copyright issues as well. But now that I have talked to you guys and you highlighted that the issues, so I think I understood it a little bit more. And with all these good messages from you guys, I really hope our viewers also take it seriously and, you know, implement it. And as we are almost at the end, so do you have any messages, you know, you want to say to your viewers, your friends or family?
I'd just like to thank you for inviting us here and thank BVS for this initiative and this platform where we can present our music to it's on national TV, so having everybody in the country being able to access our music and performance, it's a really amazing opportunity, and we'd like to thank you so much for this. And I would also like to say thank you to M Studio and Ashwin Jatso for always empowering me and inspiring me to continue my music. And yeah, I just wanted to say thank you to everyone watching us. We hope you support our music, and yeah, we will keep entertaining you as best as we can, La.
Okay.
Thank you.
For me, firstly, thank you for having us here on your program. And one thing I would like to say is, following passion is a good thing, but living in a very hard society, if we think you cannot sacrifice a lot of things, just be practical and accept that we are not able, that we cannot earn through this passion, not only music, but in any ventures of life. But that's what I believe in. I accept that I cannot pursue this career in music. So that's what I always try to say. If anyone can find that they can sustain in their passion, that is really highly appreciated. But if you think you cannot earn your living through your passion, just accept that you cannot and move forward with other things and keep this as a passion and your hobby.
Most importantly, I would like to thank His Majesty the King for making Bhutan the best place to be born in and to live in. And during this COVID situation, even as a musician, as a youth, as an artist, as a citizen, as a student, I just feel so grateful for everything that His Majesty the King has done for us and for this comfortable situation that we are in despite the COVID-19, and for the opportunities like Chikthin that we are receiving thanks to his blessings. So we would like to end by thanking His Majesty the King.
So, yeah, with powerful messages from both of you, Jurmi and Vijay. And thank you so much for, you know, choosing to appear on Music Spotlight. And thank you so much for joining me today. And to our viewers, thank you so much for joining us. Please show love and support for Jurmi Choden and Vijay. And don't forget to support our local bands too. And for more updates, follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and we also have our videos on YouTube. For now, we will leave you with a beautiful performance by Jurmi accompanied by Vijay. And more importantly, stay home, stay safe. Keep watching Music Spotlight. We'll see you next time.
And you got me like, oh, what you want from me? And I tried to buy your pretty heart, but the price is too high. And baby, you got me like, oh, your love and I fall apart. So you can put me together and throw me against the wall. And baby, you got me like, oh, oh. Don't you stop loving me, don't quit loving me, just stop loving me. And babe, I'm fist fighting with fire just to get close to you. Can you burn something, baby? And I run for miles just to get a taste. Must be love on the brain that's got me feeling this way. It beats me black and blue, but it cuts me so good and I can't get enough. Must be love on the brain. Cursing my name. No matter what I do, I'm no good without you. And I can't get enough. Must be love on the brain. Ooh. Hey, baby, just love me. Just love me. I'm fist fighting with fire just to get close to you. Can we burn something, baby? And I run for miles just to get a taste. Must be love on the brain that's got me feeling this way. It beats me black and blue, but it hurts me so good. Keeps cursing my name. No matter what I do, I'm no good without you. And I can't get enough. Must be love on the brain. The lash is up, the chin, the look, the up, the loo. Yingi gaka mado chida yasong lu. Num konale ola kalu tau da loo. Chimbom halisi silashadu.